Welcome to this NAB 2019 special. Skarhøj has a booth in Central Hall. You can come watch all our gear right there. This is a demonstration of one of the things we're exhibiting, the NXT 910 with the Skarhøj RCP. The NXT 910 is a frame synchronizer from Ensemble Designs. You can see it in their suite at the Renaissance. And you can also see it in our booth. Now, it's hooked up with a Marshall camera, which is really lovely. And in fact, you can shade that directly. But the point of the frame synchronizer is that you can combine it with an RCP if you want to adjust video sources, which are otherwise not shadable, like GoPro cameras and so forth. And the Skarhøj RCP is divided into a section where in the top you have parameters you can access, in this case, gain and offset for the incoming video. And in the lower section, you usually have a joystick, but in this case, we put in a really lovely thumb roller, or yeah, roller wheel. I think we call it a roller wheel, which is essentially an encoder that will allow you to adjust parameters. And the cool thing is you can have multiple channels and easily change between them without getting out of sync, which would be the case with a physically stuck joystick that many people prefer, but only lends itself really best to a single camera or channel. Now let's take a look at what these things can do. You can have all the details at our booth if you come down. But for those of you not at NAB, you might not be so lucky to be able to see that. Now, it has a web interface, the frame synchronizer. So it looks like this. And if I go to the prog amp section, then we have access to what might be the most important parameter on the RCP, which is namely the iris. So there is no iris adjustment in this case because it's just a video signal that could come from a GoPro camera goes into the frame synchronizer. But we can adjust the prog amp, which is kind of the closest thing we have to that. And when I'm rolling the thumb roller, you can see the gain is going up and down in the display right there. And you also see this is reflected in the web interface. If I pull the fader or the slider in the web interface, this value is changing over here. You can also see it on the output picture. Yes, you can also change channels. We put that on the upper selector in this case, so you can change to channel 2, 3, and 4. And if I go back here, then I can go into menus where you can adjust gain, red, green, and blue, offset, red, green, and blue. You can adjust gain, pedestal, chroma. And also over here, we have access to gain settings for audio, which can be 8 channels or 9 to channel 16 if you hold down this shift key for each single frame synchronizer inside this little great unit. I think it's the world's smallest frame synchronizer. You can actually line 3 of them up in a single 1-unit size. And I think that's pretty amazing. So, yes, that's what we have at display. So come to our booth and check this one out. It's, of course, our RCP is generally geared to work with cameras, like the EVA 1 camera or Sony cameras or even robotic cameras, Blackmagic cameras traditionally, but in this case, it's working with frame synchronizer. It could also be an AJA frame synchronizer like the FS4, FS2, FSHGR. Up to you. We make universal broadcast controllers and we try to support as many devices as we possibly can with different hardware form factors so that you can always pick the right control type for whatever context you're in.